I made a sinister Pokemon quiz where the answers you'd expect aren't even close. So, which of these Poke YouTubers will reign supreme? We have, who's that Pokemon? Make some noise. Riddle me this, celebrity lookalikes, Poke capitalism, and pardon my French.
I'm gonna go with who's that Pokemon for one.
Who's that Pokemon?
That is a Weeping Bell from above.
No, it's not. Shep, can you take a swing at this one?
Is it a Ghastly without the gas?
No, oh I see it now.
Gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. He's taking care of his IBS. That's incredible.
Riddle me this for one.
What did Ash say when he drank hydrogen peroxide?
Thinking back to chemistry class, is it Ho-Oh?
The answer is indeed Ho-Oh.
Yay.
I think maybe he'd be saying...
Drew, hit me with a category.
Pardon my French, for one.
In the original Japanese version of Pocket Monsters, this Pokemon is known simply as Boober.
It's Magmar, my dear friend.
Boober does equal Magmar.
I thought it was cast form. Let's get out of the one category. Let's go celebrity lookalikes for five.
If you were walking down the street, you would probably mistake Ursaring for this celeb, at least if he had pants on.
All that comes to mind is that one picture of Kevin James with the massive jorts. So, Kevin James?
No.
I don't even know his name. The one wrestler who wears the jeans. His name is like Orange Julius or something.
Orange Julius? All right, we'll put that on the screen when I know who that is.
I'm going to piggyback off Shep's answer because the jorts picture was Kevin Smith, not Kevin James.
It was none of them. Smokey the Bear.
Oh. Let's do Pokey capitalism for one.
If Pokemon existed in our world, which product would Jellicent be the mascot for?
Whoa, I'll say Powerade.
Powerade.
Blue drink.
No. Shannon, you want to have a try?
Yes, I want to have a correct try. That would be Pringles.
Oh, yes. Wow.
Let's go make some noise for two. I said two, but okay, we'll do one.
Did you say make some noise for one, Shannon? Thanks for that. Sing Jigglypuff's lullaby from the anime.
Here, I have people living upstairs. I can't.
There's a point on the line.
Okay. Jigglypuff's lullaby from the anime.
All right, time for all these years of choir as a kid to pay off.
Jigglypuff, Jigglypuff.
Wow.
That's really good. Okay, yeah. That was awesome.
Someone's asleep somewhere.
Oh, is that? Is that okay?
It was so high that Discord cut out.
Oh, it didn't get cut? Okay.
We heard bits and pieces.
Shep, you can have a point, and Drew, you can have a point.
Yay!
This is bullshit.
Let's go celebrity lookalikes for one.
This celebrity looks a lot like Diglett. Similarly, they evolved to have a close family.
I really don't even have a guess. I know this is way off. I'm just going to say the Addams family.
That's a swing and a miss. Shannon.
Is it Kim Kardashian?
Can you explain why?
I'm really interested.
The Kardashians are a family.
Just put a wig on it. It's like, I get it now. The answer is Vin Diesel.
Oh, he does. He does. Mm-hmm.
And like, look at the little like squinty eyes he's got. Turn those up. He looks just like Diglett.
Pardon my French for two.
In French, this Pokemon goes by Tadmorph.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Go, Tadmorph.
Torkoal, maybe?
It is not Torkoal. Could I get Shannon to answer?
Tadbulb.
No. No.
I thought Morph was bulb in French.
Is it Poliwhirl?
It is Grimer.
Duh.
Ta de Morph. Where in English, it translates to pile of snot.
Oh, that's
that
fun.
Makes Grimer so much worse. Who's that Pokemon for three?
Who's that Pokemon?
That is a Spheal from 90 degrees.
Let's keep moving in that direction.
91 degrees.
No.
Is it one of the dots on the Reggie trio?
No, it is not. Drew?
Clefairy from above.
It is actually from below. Oh. It's Jigglypuff from below.
It's a really unsettling angle
for
weird. Jigglypuff.
That's what you see before you die.
Here she comes.
Let's do Riddle Me This for four.
What Pokemon will Fry send out?
I will say Mabostiff. He loves his dog.
No, I'm going to have to send it over to Shannon.
He would send out Golurk because it looks like Bender. And it like farts gas and fire.
It is really good.
It's good, but not correct.
Is it Clobopus because it looks like Zoidberg?
He would send out, why not? Next, he'll send out Zoidberg.
God damn it.
Because why not Zoidberg?
Let's go Poke Capitalism for six.
What corporation would Lucario support?
I don't know corporations. Is there a time limit on how long I can think?
Yes, it's up.
No, let me guess one. McDonald's.
No, that is incorrect.
I'm going to say O'Reilly's.
O'Reilly's
best buddy. He loves Riley.
Unfortunately, Described as loyal with a strong sense of justice, Lucario wouldn't support a capitalist model.
You keep throwing me these wrenches.
Celebrity lookalikes for three.
Just like Gumshoes, this celebrity likely has the ability Strong Jaw, because they keep talking even when there's nothing to say.
Just because of the resemblance alone, I feel like I have to say Donald Trump.
You are correct.
Three points? This should have been a half a point.
What?
It's so easy.
Say, so here's the thing. The thing that I looked at was actually his posture.
Who's that Pokemon for two?
Who dat Pokemon?
Oh, Muna.
That's exactly what I wanted you to guess.
That is a Phanpy all bundled up.
That's really beautiful imagery, but incorrect. Shep?
Is it Gen 1 Sandshrew?
It's a Donphan using rollout.
Oh, I said what? Come on, give me a point. Riddle me this for two.
Lactose gives me gas. What should I spread on my morning toast?
Butterfree.
Oh my god.
Oh wow, that's perfect. Oh my gosh.
Let's go Pokey Capitalism for four.
What is this the mascot of?
Oh, every question mark block in Mario.
No. True.
I'm going to say the clothing brand, guess who?
Bing, bing, bing.
Oh wow.
We got it.
That was good.
That was a great guess. Haha.
I'll pardon my French for three.
Oh, nine. I bought a German copy of Pokemon. Which Pokemon should I use against my opponent's Glumandra?
You've been tricking me, so I'm going to say neither. They're both bad.
Neither is not a Pokemon.
Arceus, because Arceus can be any type, and so it can always have type advantage.
With all the colors you chose, I feel like it's Bisasam because you're trying to trick us.
Neither of them would get type advantage. If you said any water Pokemon, I would have given it to
you. I was going
to
say Starmie, too.
Yeah, you could have picked Shiggy. You know, good old Shiggy.
The 3D chess you played there was ridiculous.
Yeah, that wasn't even French.
Yeah, wait, what the heck?
There was only one about French so far. Wait, no. Was the first
it's
one
your
about...
quiz.
I don't know. My wife made this.
Yeah, we don't know.
Peter AI generated this quiz. Make some noise for two.
Give me your best Professor Oak quote as Professor Oak.
That was big. No, that was close. That was big.
I'm going to have to go with your first one, which was not a Professor Oak quote.
Well, I don't know. He might have said that.
Ash, you must travel the world so I can sleep with your mother.
He thought that. He didn't say that. That's not a quote. Drew, hit me with a quote and a halfway decent Professor Oak voice, and you got the points.
That's great, Ash. But Gary and all the other trainers already have four badges.
Bing, 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 bing.
Let's go riddle me this for five.
Vanna White flips the letters, but what's Pat Sajak even doing when people play Wheel of Fortune?
There's got to be a good pun here somewhere. Ghost.
That's a
really good pun. It's not the answer, but I love it.
But my immediate first thought when you asked the question was Sandy Gast. I don't know why, but...
Just tell you, just right there, flip that little white tooth. Shannon?
He ho-ost?
He Celebi. No bonus point. Where's the big Celebi?
A celebrity lookalikes for two.
This celeb is known for making music, dressing in outlandish outfits, and was even on a reality TV show.
Kiss guy is like James Simmons?
Gene Simmons was incorrect.
Okay.
Is it Kim Kardashian?
My gosh, Shannon. Absolutely not.
Is it JoJo Siwa?
Oh my gosh, Chef, you're blowing my mind.
Good job, Chef.
JoJo Siwa.
What?
That's good and topical.
Where's the pun?
It just looks like JoJo Siwa. And all of those things are correct about JoJo Siwa.
But you're just showing two pictures of Obstagoon. I don't get it.
They're the same picture.
Who's that Pokemon for four?
Who's that Pokemon?
Okay, well, that is clearly not Spiritomb. Is it a Scolipede that you're spinning around real fast?
No, it's not.
Is it Electrike running in circles?
No, it is not.
I'll go for the misdirection and say it's Spiritomb.
It's just a Beyblade on a rock.
No!
Misdirection. Who's that Pokemon that is not a Pokemon?
But the rock is Spiritomb's rock.
Okay, fine.
Let's go for Make Some Noise for five.
Your best impression of Guzzlord, buying shoes.
Give me a second. I'm just going to stand up really quick before I do this. That way I'm not super close to the mic.
Diaphragm. Sound like you yelled into a toilet. Drew, you want to give me a nice Guzzlord buying shoes?
I'm trying to remember the cry.
I thought that was your cry.
I thought that was part of it. Just in the shoe store, like, I'm trying to remember my cry, sorry. Shannon?
All right, well, hold on. Let me phone Linda upstairs and say sorry first.
Adidas!
That was so good. That's three for Shannon, because that's my number one. And one for the other two contestants.
Pokey Capitalism for two.
What does this guy sell?
I'm going to say timber.
No.
Counterfeit merchandise, because he's a knockoff of Machop.
No. Shep?
Deforestation.
It's timber plus land. He sells shoes. Specifically, Timberlands.
Oh, God, here comes Guzzlord.
He wants the shoes.
Let's go with Who's That Pokemon for five.
Who's that Pokemon?
That is a human centipede of Poliwag.
I hate that imagery, Shannon. No, I would not Photoshop that.
Oh, thank God.
I'll give the obvious answer and say Phalanx.
No.
Seedots marching.
It's six Wooloo from behind.
Oh, wow.
They're prairie dogging.
Pardon my French for four.
This is a Pokédex description that's been translated 40 times. It uses magnets to stay up. His body was strong enough to survive the plane crash.
Oh, I remember that there is a Pokemon that, like, has that dex entry of, like, basically, like, if a jet crashes into it, it's, like, fine. I know this isn't it. I'm just going to say Probopass.
Magnezone.
It is LGM.
It is none of those.
Damn.
God, do you guys even speak 40 languages? It is Metang.
Oh.
Riddle me this for three.
Could a Pokemon master beat a Jedi master? If so, how?
Roar of Time?
Oh, like a proper method to beat a Jedi master?
Yeah, just sorry, Jedi master, Roar of Time.
I'm going to say yes with Force Palm.
I'm glad you said Force Palm, because I was going to say Phantom Force.
You could beat them by Execute Order 66.
That's really good.
Just a jet comes by and drops 66 executes. But then the plan was foiled by Metang.
No! And Guzzlord comes out, steps on the eggshells. He's like, ah!
His new Timberland's ruined.
Yes!
At the end, we have to write a story using all the components of the quiz.
And JoJo Siwa was there.
For some reason.
Just to keep it kind of even, I'm going to go with Poke Capitalism for three.
What company does he run?
Why do I keep choosing Poke Capitalism when I don't know companies? Okay, so he's burning money. That is Tesla.
That's very topical. No.
I don't. BP? British Petroleum?
No.
I don't have anything better. I was going to say he's fracking. He looks like he's fracking.
Fracking awesome.
It's Excadrill Mobile.
Oh.
I'll go celebrity lookalikes for six.
Although Machoke could look like any muscle-bound celeb, I've added its lookalikes somewhere in frame.
Is it John Cena?
Oh my goodness.
Oh, very good.
You saw right through it.
Two lookalikes for four. And
Probopass is nearly a dead ringer for his celebrity lookalike. Note his distinctive mustache. Sorry, guys, there is a spelling mistake in that one.
Charlie Chaplin?
No, it's not.
You shouldn't be outing my dad like that, Peter.
Shannon's dad.
That was my guess.
No, I'm sorry.
You're gonna be. Once my dad hears about this.
Squidward's house.
Oh.
The spelling mistake was not. Instead of note, a distinctive mustache.
Oh my
gosh.
Not a distinctive mustache. Take that away. What do we got?
It was all a ploy.
Just wait until some algae blows in, then he's got a mustache.
My gosh, he looks incredible. Just like Shannon's dad.
Peter, he's married. Get over it. Give me, who's that Pokemon for six?
Who's that Pokemon?
Houndstones.
Cursola.
A Hitmonchan, chopped in half.
It's me. I was here the whole time. Yep, I do have a very bulbous head.
I just have to ask, for the Peter in the back, did you bulbous the head more, or is that...
No, actually, I unbulbous the other head so it looked more normal. That's my regular head. Friggin' Megamind over here.
Tell Crystal when she kisses you, she's not supposed to blow.
Oh my goodness.
All right, let's have some fun with Make Some Noise for three.
Do an impression of James saying one line from the Team Rocket intro.
Unite all peoples within our nation.
That was good.
James? What? Shannon?
James.
Damn, that is a line.
You're not wrong.
That is one line.
Oh my gosh. Meowth. That's right. Good job. Points for everyone.
I want Riddle Me This for six.
What's the best support to add for this player? Choose wisely.
I'll say Amoongus.
No, that is not what I'm looking for.
How about her dad? Because that is the best emotional support she can have.
Shannon, that is a beautiful sentiment and so very wrong.
A Pokemon.
I mean, that is correct, but do you have any specific?
A good one.
Yay.
The best support for her is a bra.
I thought you might say that, but I was like, I don't want to be that guy who makes that joke. God damn it, Peter.
I'm that guy. I'm hanging out with the bras right now.
And you guys are all the support I need. Let's make some noise for six.
Do an impression of Magikarp evolving into...
Oh, God.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Arnold.
That was great. That was great. I would love to hear some other attempts at it.
I really want to do the actual, like, evolution sound effect, but that would take way too long.
I'll do it in the background for you.
Oh.
Beedle-dee-doo. Dum, dum.
Carp,
don't,
carp,
don't,
carp, I'll be back.
Beautiful. Drew, what do you got for me?
Carp, Arnold.
Arnold.
It's like he was looking in the mirror. He's like, what? No?
Guys, 6 points each. Really Wowzers. And truly, they were all beautiful.
So that's the same as getting no points each.
Correct. You're all losers.
Let's go pardon my French for six.
This Pokemon often talks to its friend. Several teachers died from chest wounds.
Phalanx?
No, I'm sorry.
Kangaskhan?
No.
It is Girafarig.
You said that so confidently. Can you explain why?
Doesn't Girafarig talk to its ass? Like, telepathically?
Guys, I'm so sorry. It's beware.
Oh. Pardon my French for five.
A gust of wind revealed what hides under this Pokemon's rag to a passing trainer, who went home and died painfully that very night.
I sense trickery is what I'm saying, but a bayonet?
That's incorrect. Shannon?
Okay, but like that is describing Mimikyu, but it can't be that easy.
My God, Shannon, you've done it. Notice down bottom, it does not say it was translated at all. This is Mimikyu's actual description from Ultra Moon.
Jesus.
I guess I have to choose the last one, and it's my favorite category, Pokemon Capitalism for five.
So glad we could conclude here for you, Shannon. What is he the mascot of?
Every oil company.
No, we already did the oil company.
I'm debating how gross I want to be with this answer.
Oh, goodness.
Pornhub?
Disgusting.
Do we know this album?
Yes.
Yeah, we do. Who's that by? We get McDonald's, baby. Oh.
Peter?
Yes?
I'm going to kill you in real life until you're dead.
We have tallied the points. 24 for Drew.
Woo! Woo. It's not me.
25 for Shannon.
Ah, it's me.
And in first place with a total score of 28 is Shepsky. Your prize is a can of beans.
Oh, boy.
Hey.
And if you aren't happy with those beans, you can have these beans.
So dumb.
Ta-da! Thank you for watching, and subscribe for more ridiculous Pokemon videos.